If there's one single person that is killing it as a YouTuber with the ideas and the videos on the platform, I think that it is Dixie D'Amelio. This girl is skyrocketing with these ideas, she is using her potential, and she is diversifying her content in probably the best way possible. Diversifying? I don't know. She is really, really good at making herself present in her videos, and she's also doing different collabs, and not with just other YouTubers, but other music artists as well. This video is going to be about her ideas, her diversification, and why it is making her one of the best on the YouTube platform currently. Not only has she started out the right way on this platform, because, I mean, who doesn't want to see a room tour of somebody that is famous that they might look up to? But she has also done a couple of really good collabs with Casey Neistat and James Charles where they go surfing and do their makeup.
How do you like YouTube making YouTube videos versus making TikTok?
So early on, she had already established herself as this new person where it's like, get to know me, let me tell you a little bit about myself, and let me go with these other creators. That way you can see some familiar faces and not just reject me right off the bat, even though I was already famous on an app like TikTok. She took advantage of the momentum, took her place on the platform of YouTube, and then she made her music artist debut with Be Happy. This is the part where I personally see her benefiting the most, if not from the makeup, then from her music artist career. The amount of revenue alone that she will generate from this to be able to reinvest back into her brand of Dixie D'Amelio, well, her personality at that, it is insane the potential that she has now. And, I mean, you know, not to mention just the casual approach of collabing with Black Bear and Lil Mosey. Wait, I don't know who Lil Mosey is, this is the first time I've ever heard of him, but Black Bear, I listen to Black Bear all the time. And this is an awesome collab that they did. I really think it works especially well because this Be Happy single is a hit. I mean, it was right off the bat just a hit on Dixie D'Amelio's own platform alone with her own audience. And then Black Bear comes in and Lil Mosey come in. I think Black Bear's verse is really, really good. He does this catchy alternative key moment with one of his older songs, which, well, he put into Dixie D'Amelio's lyrics for this song.
Fuck you and you and you. It's fuck you and you.
I mean, it's a remix of her Be Happy song, but he kind of took us back to the memories of his own music. One of the things that I noticed as well is that when you are making music, if you make a hit, it's kind of really hard to emulate that hit again with a remix. Like, usually the remix is never as good as the hit itself, but in this case, it kind of made it better. One thing that I've really noticed for sure is that Dixie is playing it really smart with getting to know these creators, putting herself out there, making these connections, making herself more known on the platform itself. Not just on TikTok, but, well, she's making her career expand into ways that it will actually last, and she's still very, very young for that matter. And on the topic of creating a brand that lasts, well, she has her own talk show now. It's not just a YouTube channel anymore, but it's Talking with Dixie D'Amelio. I think the early late show with Dixie D'Amelio. And she's even fighting with Addison Rae. Like, this is a good video to watch and get to know these creators in this kind of atmosphere. So it's you get the best of both worlds. You get the chill, sit-down moments where you get to know these creators in their intimate moments, where people ask them questions about, we are your fans and we want to know the dirty little secrets that you guys might have, especially with her and her ex, I think he is, or maybe they're currently dating. If they aren't dating, then it's really cool how he's always flirting with her, and, well, she flirts back. She takes the more timid, like, hard-to-get type of approach.
What can I do? Like, what can I do to make you mine, you
know?
And then she gets flirted with again by her coach, who goes 20-0 apparently. I don't think that her and Addison sparring in a boxing ring is necessarily the most entertaining thing ever because, well, they are both really playful with it. I mean, it's still kind of an approach to entertainment, but I think it's better watching this dude flirt with her the whole time. Especially when he's in her corner cheering her on, and then he picks her up at the end, like she is the princess to his world. Now, as I'm talking about these things, they're probably just all like a compilation of content thrown at her audience and, well, yourselves for watching this video. But all in all, these are really, really great ideas on their own. It's one thing to just make this content and grow your audience and push entertainment out there to the people that will watch, but it's another totally different story to push these ideas out there in the terms of growing your brand and growing your awareness and growing your diversification on these platforms. It's really hard to get famous on one platform, but getting famous on multiple is, well, basically unheard of, for most people at least. David Dobrik is not one of those people. But in this case, Dixie does take the cake, and she's doing it in one of the best ways and most efficient ways possible, and probably ever before. this is what social media has come to and what it is allowing people to do. The people that can succeed, well, if they do it right, they have no boundaries, basically. The point that Dixie should be making here is branding, content, marketing, establishment, and long-lasting, all of those things. She's doing that really, really well. All she has to do is continue with these kind of ideas that make people will want to pay attention. And that's basically it, because she's doing everything else pretty efficiently. It's no question that she's definitely blossoming from the early content days that were just a few months ago versus today, where she is hosting her own show and, well, creating a boxing match type of situation. So that is why I think that there is definitely some geniusness behind Dixie D'Amelio and her approach to making YouTube videos or content in general. I think that she has a really big chance, along with Charlie, to be one of the greatest content creators of her generation, and, well, currently, everywhere. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video, I hope you have a good day or night, and I will see you in the next video. Peace.